And we're spinning, and all I could see was colors.
Sierra Faulkner made it back to her house in Denton moments before a massive tree was uprooted in her front yard, landing squarely on her family's pickup.
Front windows, back windows blew out. Just a bunch of glass, like, crushing. Kind of like if a bomb were to blow up.
It is going to take months to clean up the debris left by this storm. Meantime, the Van Independent School District has canceled classes here.
Its Facebook page reads,
"Prayers for our town." Gail?
Thank you, Vicente. A tornado in Iowa caused a big scare when it tore through a high school last night.
There goes the school!
Yay. About 100 people were inside that school in Lake City on Sunday when the twister just ripped the roof right off. Nobody was hurt there, but nearly everybody was shaken up.
It was really dark when fire had gone off. It was a long, but it was a pop. We didn't hear the roof come off, and there was a change of pressure. I thought my ears were going to pop. That's what it felt like to me.
Where the storm left a trail of destruction two blocks wide in Lake City, that's northwest of Des Moines.
Subtropical storm Anna is a tropical depression this morning, spinning over the eastern Carolinas. Anna made landfall 3 weeks before the start of the Atlantic hurricane season. It is the earliest named storm in decades. Anna brought rain and strong winds to the Carolinas over the weekend. It is expected to move through eastern Virginia today, then push out to the sea.
Take a look at this. Mother's Day was snowed out in parts of the Northern Plains. Some areas of Colorado, Nebraska, and the Dakotas got more than a foot of snow. In Denver, the Colorado Rockies had to shovel Coors Field on Sunday before the home team lost to the Dodgers. Meteorologist Scott Padgett of our Dallas-Fort Worth station, KTVT, is watching today's severe weather threat. Scott, good morning.
Good morning. More severe weather expected through the day today in the Central Plains. Cold front is slamming its way eastward. So from Houston all the way up through Memphis, there is a slight risk of severe storms. That stretches all the way up into parts of Michigan with that cold front working its way into very warm and moist air. So there's the potential of supercell storms, damaging tornadoes. Wind damage threat also is possible with golf ball to baseball size hail. And it spreads over a really large area, 416,000 square miles in the risk area and nearly 57.5 million people affected. That cold front will continue to spark off storms this morning and then into the afternoon hours, late afternoon in parts of Louisiana and Mississippi. There's the potential of those severe storms going into the afternoon hours to late evening hours for us with the potential of tornadoes. Gail?
Oh boy, thank you, Scott. Four people facing charges in the deaths of two Mississippi police officers are due in court today. The community gathered last night for a candlelight vigil to remember the officers. They were gunned down Saturday night after a routine traffic stop. Anna Warner's in Hattiesburg, Mississippi, with what happened. Anna, good morning.
Good morning, Gail. This is the impromptu memorial to those two officers who were shot. One was a decorated officer of the year, the other a proud newcomer to the force.
It was about 8:30 Saturday night when Officer Benjamin Dean stopped a gold Cadillac Escalade for speeding. Police say he had probable cause to search the vehicle and called for backup when he saw four people inside. 25-year-old rookie officer LaCorey Tate arrived on the scene just before shots were fired.
I was upstairs in my kitchen and I heard six loud gunshots.
Dean and Tate were rushed to a hospital and pronounced dead.
They worked feverishly to try and save both. It just wasn't so. Too much blood was lost. And too much damage done internally.
Within 4 hours of the shooting, three suspects were arrested. A fourth, 28-year-old Cornelius Clark, was apprehended Sunday afternoon and charged with obstruction of justice. 29-year-old Marvin Banks and 22-year-old Joni Calloway were charged with the officers' murders. Banks' younger brother, Curtis, was charged as an accessory to murder. In custody, he declared his innocence.
I'm going to take another to the test, sir. God knows I ain't doing nothing.
Dean, a member of the K-9 unit and 2012 Officer of the Year, leaves behind a wife and two children. The father of LaCorey Tate took to Facebook after learning of his son's death. He said, "Well, Lord, I had been praying it was all just a mistake. My baby, I just need some kind of mercy right now."
No parent wants to bury their child before them. And here we are on Mother's Day. It's a tragedy for all America. It's a tragedy for our community.
It's the first time in 30 years that an officer has been killed in the line of duty in Hattiesburg. The city will hold a memorial for the two officers later today, Charlie.
Anna, thanks. An important summit of Gulf Arab leaders with President Obama gets underway this week without a key player. Saudi Arabia says King Salman will stay home. Word came just 2 days after the White House said he would attend. Margaret Brennan is at the State Department with the growing Arab concern about Iran. Margaret, good morning.
Good morning. Well, Saudi Arabia insists that this is not a snub, but it is a disappointment for the White House. President Obama had sought to personally reassure Arab leaders about the upcoming nuclear deal with Iran, their longtime adversary. Saudi Arabia, already frustrated with U.S. inaction in Syria, is also concerned that Iran will carry out more attacks in the region if the U.S. lifts sanctions as part of that deal. So to offset worry, the White House had offered to sell them more weapons, but stopped short of promising to militarily defend its Arab allies, the exact type of security pact they seek. Now, the White House says there's no major disagreement, and Saudi Arabia says, well, the king needed to stay home to oversee a five-day ceasefire in its military campaign in Yemen. But this cancellation also prompted the king of Bahrain to pull out. Now, only two of the six monarchs invited to meet with President Obama will actually be doing so. They'll all send their deputies, but the fact that heads of state will not be there gives this summit a harder time when it comes to making decisions and lends less diplomatic heft, Nora, than the White House had hoped for. Margaret, thanks. It's a big deal.
It is a big deal. But the interesting thing, too, is that he says he's staying home to see what's happening in Yemen, the ceasefire in Yemen. The two people most responsible for prosecuting that Yemen attack are going to be in Washington with the president.
That's right, the two younger princes,
right,
who are very...
Crown Prince and the deputy crown prince.
Who are very crucial. All right, Margaret, thank you again. Former President Jimmy Carter is back home this morning in Georgia after getting sick in South America. Mr. Carter landed Sunday in Atlanta. Here you see him standing with the crew from our affiliate WGCL, which followed the 90-year-old to Guyana. He was set to observe national elections there today. The 39th president told WGCL that a, quote, virus cut his trip short, but his staff says he went straight back to work yesterday at the Carter Center. Quite amazing, the former president there at 90 years old. Yeah, still going strong.
Driving around the world.
Glad to see he's okay. First Lady Michelle Obama is receiving praise this morning for a commencement address at Tuskegee University. Her speech on Saturday offered some of her most candid remarks on how she's grown into her historic role. Jan Crawford is in Washington with the emotional speech. Jan, good morning.
Good morning. So, you know, Tuskegee is a historically black university in Alabama. It's been home to some of the nation's most prominent African-American pioneers. And it was there, before the school's newest graduating class, that Michelle Obama talked about how she's learned to ignore criticism as America's first African-American First Lady.
In her deeply personal speech, Michelle Obama told new graduates she wasn't always the fully formed First Lady that addressed them Saturday.
I had a lot of sleepless nights worrying about what people thought of me.
She mentioned the persistent questions about her husband's citizenship, the fist bump with then-candidate Obama that was dubbed a terrorist fist jab, which led to the controversial 2008 New Yorker magazine cover, an image Obama said knocked her back a bit. And then there were the critics who used racially charged language.
Cable news charmingly referred to me as Obama's baby mama.
She told the graduates they would have to learn to ignore the criticism.
The road ahead is not going to be easy. It never is, especially for folks like you and me.
She said she and the president know what it's like when people look past them, seeing just a fraction of who they really are.
The people at formal events who assumed we were the help, and those who have questioned our intelligence, our honesty, even our love of this country.
But she said for others, the experiences can be so much worse.
Those nagging worries that you're going to get stopped or pulled over for absolutely no reason.
Alluding to the uprisings in Baltimore and Ferguson, she said while those problems are rooted deep, that's no excuse to give up.
To succumb to feelings of despair and anger only means that in the end, we lose.
Trisha Rose, who heads the Center for the Study of Race and Ethnicity at Brown University, said Obama's message can have a big impact.
This saturates our world. Don't think I am so lofty to be above this mistreatment. And on the other hand, she's saying, even with all of that, there are some ways to continue to fight and to hold on to what you believe in.
Now, Mrs. Obama also talked about feeling invisible, you know, that as hard as you try, you just don't matter. And those are themes that were explored back in 1953 in Ralph Ellison's iconic book, Invisible Man. And she pointed out to the new graduates that Ellison was one of the many pioneers who got their start at Tuskegee and went on to greatness. Nora?
Jan, thanks. That is a speech worth reading from beginning to end. Everyone should take a look at that. Thank you, Jan. A new report is adding to the controversy surrounding the Clinton Foundation. New York Magazine says the Clintons worked behind the scenes to put pressure on a charity watchdog. Author Gabriel Sherman writes they wanted Charity Navigator to remove the foundation from a watch list. He says the Clintons tried to strong-arm the group by contacting a board member. The article also says a Clinton advisor urged the foundation to appoint a Republican as co-chair to insulate them from partisan attacks.
Prince gave a concert in Baltimore last night and told a crowd of thousands that the system is broken. The so-called Rally for Peace after the recent protest over the death of Freddie Gray was a three-hour show. Prince performed his hits, plus several encores. The set list included the new song, Baltimore. The lyrics include these lines: does anybody hear us pray for Michael Brown or Freddie Gray? Peace is so much more than the absence of war. The streaming service Tidal carried a live audio stream of the concert's first hour. Friends said that a portion of the proceeds would support Baltimore youth charities.
This morning, Cuban President Raul Castro is considering rejoining the Catholic Church. He met with Pope Francis at the Vatican yesterday. Castro says he wanted to thank the Pope personally for the Vatican's role in reestablishing diplomatic relations between the United States and Cuba. Alan Pizzi is in Vatican City and shows us the Church's role in the talks.
It wasn't water into wine, but Pope Francis may have turned Cuban President Raul Castro back into a believer. Speaking after their meeting at the Vatican, the communist leader said, quote, if the Pope continues this way, I will go back to praying and go back to the church, adding, and I'm not joking. But it may have been this handshake that really won the Cuban leader over. The end of 50 years of isolation between Washington and Havana was engineered by the Vatican. The key building block was exchanging five Cuban spies imprisoned in the U.S. for American contractor Alan Gross, who was being held in a Cuban jail. Pope Francis told President Obama that improving relations with Cuba would have broad benefits for Washington throughout Latin America, and dispatched Cuban Cardinal Jaime Ortega to sound out Raul Castro. Then, using the ruse of a speech at Georgetown University to get him to Washington without arousing suspicion, Cardinal Ortega was spirited into the White House to speak directly for the Pope. Senator Patrick Leahy was involved from the earliest stages.
I think both the Cubans and the U.S. team could say, okay, we agree with Pope Francis, it's time.
Cuban and American negotiators met twice in the secure confines of Vatican City and at least nine times in Ottawa and Toronto. Francis took no public credit, but was no doubt more than pleased at adding another member to his faithful flock. For CBS This Morning, Alan Pizzi, Vatican City.
Cleanup crews this morning are trying to contain thousands of gallons of oil that leaked into the Hudson River. A transformer fire on Saturday at New York's Indian Point nuclear power plant sent the black smoke billowing to the sky. Oil in the transformers seeped into a holding tank. The fluid then entered the river through a discharge drain. Anti-nuclear activists are calling for the power plant to shut down after a series of mishaps at this facility.
Stunning claims about the death of Osama bin Laden. Pulitzer Prize winner Seymour Hersh says he was killed with the help of the Pakistanis. CIA insider Michael Morell is here in Studio 57. We'll ask Morell, who briefed the president that day, about some of these new claims, plus revelations from his own new book. But first, it is 7:19, time to check your local weather.
We're starting off this morning extremely warm, humid, and low visibilities continue to be a problem all across central Virginia. We're down to zero right now in Louisa as well as into Orange. Be careful as you're headed out on those roadways. And Kristen, how are the roads right now?
The roads are looking okay, but just like you said, low visibilities out there, Nikki D. This is Interstate 95 close to Route 54 in Ashland. Bridge work gets underway this evening, but right now make sure that you are aware fog is the concern.
This National Weather Report sponsored by Toyota. Let's go places.
Hi. Looking for a Prius, I bet.
It's high tech too, with the latest safety features and available Entune app suite. And I'm sorry, I don't mean to drone on. Honey, stop messing with Jan.
During Toyota time, get 0% APR financing for 60 months on a 2015 Prius. Offer ends June 1st. For great deals on other Toyotas, visit Toyota.com.
Enjoy your Prius.
Thanks, Jan.
Look out, people coming in hot.
Toyota, let's go places.
Some celebrities are keeping their lawns nice and wet during California's record-setting drought.
Ahead, the aerial photos showing who seems to be ignoring the water shortage.
The news is back in the morning right here on CBS This Morning.
Now at Chili's, new top shelf ranchero chicken tacos. Stop in for lunch and tap, swipe, and go. Chili's, fresh. It's happening now.
Your allergies bring more than sneezing and itchy eyes. They also bring tough nasal congestion. So you need Claritin D. It starts to work in just 30 minutes. In fact, nothing works faster. So blow away nasal congestion fast with Claritin D.
How much protein does your dog food have? 18%? 20? Introducing nutrient-dense Purina ONE True Instinct with real salmon and tuna and 30% protein. Support your active dog's whole body health with Purina ONE.
You wouldn't do half of your daily routine. So, why treat your mouth any differently? Brushing alone does less than half the job, leaving behind millions of germs. Clean the job with Listerine. Kill up to 99% of germs and prevent plaque, early gum disease, and bad breath. Complete the job with Listerine. Power to your mouth. Also try Listerine Floss. Its advanced technology removes more plaque.
It's hard finding time to moisturize your skin every day. With microdroplets of Vaseline Jelly, new Vaseline Intensive Care Spray. Moisturizes and absorbs in seconds to help heal dry skin. So there's always time for healed skin. That's the healing power of Vaseline in seconds.
Why am I so awake?
Did you know your brain has a wake system and a sleep system? Science suggests when you have insomnia, the neurotransmitters in your wake system may be too strong, which may be preventing you from getting the sleep you need. Talk to your doctor about ways to manage your insomnia.
The ultimate do-over for wood and concrete. Don't replace, resurface. Behr Premium Deckover, exclusively at the Home Depot.
Shattering service. That's the new Buick.
Introducing lunch at Outback every bloomin' day. Hurry in for all your Outback favorites. Plus new Aussie tacos, new savory ribeye melt, and our delicious burgers. Over 70 lunch combinations starting at just $6.99. It's lunch at last every day at Outback.
PetSmart Charities brings thousands of pets and families together inside your local PetSmart. When you adopt, your heart grows, and the dark isn't so scary anymore. This weekend, adopt a pet and save a life. PetSmart Charities.
On autopilot when it comes to sensitive teeth, stop numbing. Now you can repair. New Colgate Sensitive Toothbrush with built-in sensitivity relief pen shields exposed nerves, relieving pain by repairing sensitive teeth. Stop numbing, start repairing.
My feet felt so heavy at the end of the day.
They used to get really tired.
Until I started gelling.
I got Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles.
When they're in my shoes, my feet and legs feel less tired.
It's like walking on a wave.
Dr. Scholl's massaging gel insoles.
I'm a believer.
When you feel good, no one is immune. With antioxidants, electrolytes, and B vitamins, plus more vitamin C than 10 oranges, emergency transforms more than just water. Emergency. Let your awesome out.
More real news. That's our promise to you. CBS This Morning.
Hi, I'm Joel Beaver. If you've been hurt, call the name you know. Hi, I'm Joel Beaver. Hi, I'm Joel Beaver. If you're hurt, we're available 24 hours a day. Hi, I'm Joel Beaver. Some folks ask, Joel, can't you do a more formal commercial? For over 20 years, I've been saying, we come to you, and we still come to you. Call the Joel Beaver firm or go to joelbeaver.com.
Call Joel Beaver.
Frustrated Atlanta principal is under fire for what some call racist remarks during the graduation ceremony. See what she says now for what caused the outburst.
And tomorrow on CBS This Morning, a woman who says that a moving company effectively held her belongings hostage for more money. The disturbing and growing trend. Tomorrow, your local news is coming up next. Situation's terrible.
Working for you. This is CBS 6 This Morning.
Well, good morning to you. I'm Reba Hollingsworth. Let's get a check of weather and traffic. Let's start with Nikki D. Hi, Nikki D.
Hey, Reba. We're starting off this morning nice and warm. Current temperatures coming in at 69 degrees. And check a look at that humidity, 93%. With so much moisture, we are dealing with some fog. So be careful out on those roadways. Some locations, such as in Orange, Louisa, down to zero visibility. Charlottesville coming in at a quarter of a mile. 5 miles right now in Richmond, Williamsburg coming in at 2.5. Be careful out on those roadways. Of course, we will be dealing with some low visibility for the next bit. But what about Anna? She's finally beginning to push further into the region. We are seeing a few light showers just to the north and west of Williamsburg. And this will continue to be the trend. The heaviest amount of rain will simply stay well off towards our east. Temperatures right now coming in 67 degrees in Ashland, 68 right downtown. And you head further off towards the east where we are flirting right around the 70 degree mark. By the afternoon, those temperatures do begin to rebound. And we are looking to see some isolated showers and thunderstorms this morning as well as the afternoon. Kristen?
Thanks, Nikki D. Just like you said, be careful. Watch for those low visibilities. This is seen just north of Richmond and Doswell. Interstate 95 is actually the southbound side there to the right side of the screen. And it looks like folks are able to get by to the left side, 95 north. So if your commute takes you just north of town, make sure that you are staying aware. Out to our maps we go. Problems on the board that you need to know about. Let's start you off in the Prince George area, just off Oaklawn Boulevard. It's in the westbound direction at Temple Avenue. So just as you're coming off Interstate 295, if you're trying to connect to Fort Lee maybe or to Temple Avenue, Route 144, you may encounter some flashing lights. Heads up there, it's all on the left shoulder. One more problem, this should be in the clearing stages. Now dealing with this since earlier, Fendel Avenue and Crawford Street. Make it a good one.
Allen and Allen, we know that a personal injury can change your life forever.
We've dedicated our lives to fighting for you.
We're Allen and Allen. Call us.
At Martin's, you'll find more ways than ever to save. It starts with everyday low prices on the items you buy most, then grows with bonus buy savings on thousands of items every week, plus personal e-bonus offers. Add in fuel perks, and the savings truly stack up. Come see how much you can save now at Martin's. And now, you'll find new lower prices on even more of your favorite grocery items across the store. Low everyday prices now at Martin's.
When you come to a place with an idea of what you want to be, the most discouraging thing in the world is when they tell you a list of reasons why it can't happen. You want to come to a place like Straya with this big idea, this notion that you're going to be more than who you are right now, and you want them to say, okay, this is how it's done. That's all you want, man.
CBS 6 Traffic, powered by James River Air.
If your child is sick or injured and needs after-hours or weekend emergency care, remember, they're not small adults. Children and teens have specific needs.
KidMed is the only dedicated pediatric after-hours urgent care in the Richmond area with board-certified pediatricians always on site. We've treated thousands of children's illnesses and injuries. It's what we do. We're open 365 days a year and accept most insurance.
When it comes to your kids, put your trust in KidMed. We are Richmond's pediatric urgent care experts.
Doppler Max 6 is sponsored by the law firm of Allen & Allen. The injury attorneys of Allen & Allen are here to fight for compensation for your injuries. Visit AllenAndAllen.com.
Win a $600 Walmart gift card. Watch tomorrow.
A stage collapsed under the weight of an 80-person choir in China over the weekend. The choir was singing when you see the group just dramatically disappeared from view. 8 people were hurt, 2 are in serious condition. No word yet on what caused the stage to give way, but there was a lot of weight on that stage. It's always scary to see that happen. Welcome back to CBS This Morning. Coming up in this half hour, a new warning about an attack on the scale of 9/11. CIA insider Michael Morell is in Studio 57 this morning with a growing concern about the ability of ISIS to strike inside the U.S., plus his new book that gives a fresh perspective to the CIA's fight.
Plus, exposing celebrity water wasters. The drought-shaming trend in California is targeting the lush landscapes of celebrity homes. That story is ahead.
It is time to show you some of this morning's headlines. The CEO of oil production company ConocoPhillips spoke with Maria Bartiromo for USA Today. Ryan Lance says he thinks that crude oil prices will be lower and more volatile in the next few years. Lance says that his company is reducing capital spending by up to 30% this year. From last year.
The New York Times has a follow-up on its story about nail salon workers. On Sunday, the governor of New York ordered emergency measures to protect workers from wage theft and health hazards in the workplace. Reporter Sarah Maslin-Neer wrote the article and was in Studio 57 on Friday. The new rules for nail salon workers are effective immediately.
I went and got my nails done this weekend, guys, and 3 people in the salon said, "How many hours do you work and how are you paid?"
Everyone was talking about
it. It was fascinating to watch that in action.
Absolutely.
New Jersey Star Ledger says the Jets took $377,000 from taxpayers to salute National Guard soldiers. The honors appear to be a generous gesture by the team, but the salutes were part of a military program that paid 14 NFL teams more than $5 million. In a statement, the Pentagon says this, quote, "Recruiting and outreach are important, but we are concerned by this spending."
And the Washington Post looks at a warning. The United States has entered a new phase in fighting the global terror threat. Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson says lone wolf attackers inspired by ISIS could strike at any moment. This morning, CIA insider Mike Morell is giving us a new look at the CIA's efforts to prevent the next attack. Morell served as deputy director until his retirement in 2013. He briefed President Obama before the raid that killed Osama bin Laden. And on 9/11, Morell was traveling with President Bush when he learned of the attacks. He is now CBS News senior security contributor. His new book is The Great War of Our Time, the CIA's fight against terrorism from Al-Qaeda to ISIS. Good morning.
Charlie, it's good to be here.
Let me start with the whole business about ISIS's threat. I mean, your sense of that how big it is and what could it be?
So I think it's growing every day. I think the statement by Jay Johnson is a reflection of that. I think what the administration is trying to do is trying to set expectations for the American people. They're basically saying there's going to be another attack, and we need to understand that when it happens.
Beyond understanding, what do we have to do?
We have to do whatever we can, right, to stop guys who went to Iraq and Syria from coming back to the United States, and we have to try to get a better handle on the self-radicalization that's taking place with these lone wolves.
And you write that they have a very effective social media campaign that we do not have, and we haven't seemed to be able to get under control with these guys.
I mean, it's Madison Avenue quality social media that's radicalizing these guys. It's very difficult to shut it down because of the nature of the internet, right? If you shut it down over here, it pops right back up over here.
But you're concerned about another 9/11 style attack, or scale attack, right, rather. After everything we've learned and changed after 9/11, you really think something like that scale could happen again?
So one of the things I talk about in the book, one of the key lessons of the fight against terrorists is you have to keep the pressure on them. If you keep the pressure on them, you make it very difficult for them to plot, you make it very difficult for them to plan, you make it very difficult for them to attack because they're worried about their own security. Mm-hmm. As soon as you take that pressure off, they start rebuilding. We've seen that over and over and over again. So if we don't keep the pressure on, we're going to see another 9/11 style attack. That's the main message of the book.
We want to talk about your book, The Great War of Our Time, and more about this, but also Seymour Hersh, the reporter for the New Yorker magazine, has published an article in a London publication basically saying that the Obama administration has not been clear and open with us, that there was a single unnamed source, he says. He says they got a, U.S. got assistance from Pakistani officials, that Osama bin Laden was held captive. He was not living there alone, and that the body was not disposed. All of these things come as a jarring sense of what we were not told. Can you tell us, is any of this true?
It's all wrong. I started reading the article last night. I got a third of the way through and I stopped because every sentence I was reading was wrong. The source that Hersh talked to has no idea what he's talking about.
You know who the source is?
I have no idea. Okay. But the person obviously was not close to what actually happened. The Pakistanis did not know. I talk about in the book how we actually made a decision. The president made a decision not to tell the Pakistanis. The Pakistanis were furious with us. The president sent me to Pakistan after the raid to try to start smoothing things over. Pakistanis did not know. This article is wrong.
He suggested there was a single Pakistani official that got $25 million for telling you.
Not true.
Let me turn to what's in the news also today, because the president, of course, trying to negotiate with Iran. There's a big Arab summit that's planned, and after the White House publicly saying that the king of Saudi Arabia was coming to the meeting, we learned from the Saudis that he's not coming. Is this a snub?
So I think we got to be a little bit careful with why he's not coming. It's very possible that in the next 24, 48 hours, we may learn that it's a health reason, for example. So he's got to be a little careful. Now, having said that, it is absolutely true that the Sunni Arab states are deeply frustrated with the United States over our policy. And fundamentally, they are more concerned, more afraid of Iran than they are of Al-Qaeda and ISIS. And they want our total support in their struggle against Iran. Iran wants to be the regional hegemonic power, and the Sunni Arab states are pushing back against us. They want our support. I think they deserve it.
What is it they want that we're not doing?
They want us to put as much pressure on the Iranians as we possibly can, right?
But they want a defense pact, and they want the F-35, which we're not going to give them.
Exactly.
Yeah.
One of the reasons you write, Mike, in the book, number one, you take us totally behind the scenes about Osama bin Laden, that you were one of the few people that knew exactly when it was going to happen and how it was going to happen. I finished this book and thought, what a badass Mike Morrell is. And he just comes here like a regular, humble sort of guy. I have to say, I was very, very impressed with all that you've done. But you say that one of the reasons you wanted to write this book was because you wanted people to understand the CIA, and we do not understand the CIA.
There are a number of myths out there about the agency. You know, one myth is kind of a Jack Ryan myth, which is we can do anything. We can discover any secret. Another myth is kind of a Maxwell Smart. Everything these guys touch, right, falls apart.
Yeah.
And another myth is kind of the Jason Bourne myth, which is we're rogue, right? We're doing all these things without any oversight from the executive branch or Congress. All of those myths are wrong. The truth is these are incredibly dedicated people trying to do the right thing every day for the country. They get many, many things right. And like any organization, we get some things wrong.
And you talk about the things you got wrong.
Including, it was interesting to read about, because one of the questions that many people have still is, how did we get the intelligence wrong on Iraq? And it's specifically Saddam Hussein's alleged ties to Al-Qaeda and weapons of mass destruction. What did we get wrong?
We got wrong the weapons of mass destruction piece. We said he has chemical weapons, he has a biological weapons production capability, and he's restarting his nuclear weapons program. We were wrong on all three of those. On Iraq and Al-Qaeda, we said there is no link, right? And we were right about that.
But you say Secretary Powell has expressed chagrin that he went out there, made that case to not only the UN, to the world, and that he has said over the years, no one from the intelligence community has ever apologized to him. But you're now doing that.
Yes, I did in the book. I thought it important to do so because here's a man with an incredible reputation, well-deserved over a long period of time, and he went out there, made this case, and we were wrong. And this has been on him, in a sense, for a very long period of time.
He
so
says,
I wanted to apologize.
He says it'll be the first line in his obituary in terms of what happened there. He spent several days at Langley.
Yes, he did.
How could you not have apologized to him, not you, but the CIA, but people who knew that he did not know, and he went out there under full glare of world attention at the UN.
Yeah, I was not a senior official at the time. Right? I was a kind of a mid-level official. So it wasn't up to me to apologize.
Somebody should have apologized, shouldn't they?
I think so. And that's what I did in the book.
Before now, what was his reaction to the apology? You must have let him know it was coming.
So I sent him a chapter. I sent him that chapter. He called me, and he was deeply appreciative of the apology.
Well, very interesting
it's
reading.
A very interesting
yeah.
book. Yeah.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, I mean, and talk about timely too. You're on the cover of USA Today, Above the Fold.
Yeah. How many presidents did you serve?
Six, three Republican, three Democrat.
That's why there's so much in this book. Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Michael Morell.
Thank you very much. Some of the biggest stars in L.A. have some of the greenest lawns. How is that possible with this drought? A new effort to shame celebrities into cutting down their water use. That's next. But if you're heading off to work and you don't want to miss the rest of this broadcast, you do not have to do that. Set your DVR so you can watch CBS This Morning anytime you feel like it. We'll be there. We'll be right back.
Would you like to be a Publisher's Clearinghouse winner next month? You can win $2 million plus $10,000 a month for life and a new car. Enter at PCH.com and June 30th, you could win it all.
You make my dreams come true.
Wolves, the wild ancestors of your dog. They share many traits, like a love for meat. So Blue Wilderness has more of the chicken, duck, or salmon your dog desires. Try Blue Wilderness, because he's wild inside.
In my bakery, I see customers every day. But some days, I felt like all they saw was my acne, not me. I couldn't believe I still had acne. So I went to Axone.com, found a dermatologist, and asked her about Axone Dapsone Gel. Together, we decided Axone Gel was right for me, and my acne got better.
Acne is a medical condition that can happen at any age. Fortunately, your doctor can prescribe Axone Gel, FDA approved for the topical treatment of acne and proven in clinical studies with people 12 years and older. Talk to your doctor about any medical conditions you have, including G6PD deficiency, and any medications you are using. Use of benzoyl peroxide with Axone Gel may cause your skin to temporarily turn yellow or orange at the site of application. The most common side effects with Axone Gel are dryness, redness, oiliness, and peeling of treated skin. Now you can pay no more than $10 for Axone Gel. Get your coupon and learn more at Axone.com. Axone Gel. Prescription treatment. Proven results.
When you build a better vacuum, word gets around.
Get a Shark.
Shark gets more 5-star online reviews than any other vacuum brand. The Shark Rotator converts from an upright to a powered lift-away, so you can deep clean carpets in even the toughest places.
Get a Shark.
Independent lab tests prove that Shark has more suction and deep cleans carpets better than a high-priced Dyson. So,
get a Shark
and go where no vacuum has gone before.
73% of Americans try to cook healthy meals, yet up to 90% fall short in getting key nutrients from food alone. Let's do more. Add one a day men's 50 plus, complete with key nutrients we may need. Plus, it helps support healthy blood pressure with vitamin D and magnesium.
I found a happy place. It's written on my face. We're singing, we're singing. I found a happy place. Oh, found a happy place. I'm singing, I'm singing. I found a happy place.
With ingredients like roasted hazelnuts, skim milk, and cocoa, there's a whole lot of happy in every jar of Nutella. Spread the happy.
Would you like to be a Publisher's Clearinghouse winner next month? You can win $2 million plus $10,000 a month for life and a new car. Enter at PCH.com and June 30th, you could win it all.
You make my dreams come true.
Look who just posted a naughty selfie.
You were in this pose with your yobbles out? Didn't I raise you better than this?
A new two broke girls. Then, to say something big's going down on Mike and Molly. It's like saying this car needs a new roof.
I gotta go change my pants.
A new Mike and Molly right after a new two broke girls. CBS Tonight.
This is the Town Bank logo, a symbol of who we are and what we believe. It's no coincidence that the first word of our name is Town. We're proud to bring hometown banking to Richmond, and we're deeply committed to this community. Town Bank, a frankly different bank.
What's happened to snacking? How did it become absent-mindedly eating one after the next?
We are a creamy cheese that still believes in savoring our food. The Laughing Cow. Reinvent snacking.
California starts restricting water use in a few weeks because of the state's devastating drought. Everyone is under orders to cut back, even celebrities who can afford to pay the fines. Carter Evans shows us a new effort to spotlight big names who are also huge water users.
Take one look at these celebrity mansions and you'll see a stark contrast between the green grounds inside the property versus the brown land outside. A recent study says many living California's lush life are doing so surrounded by lush lawns, despite the dirt-dry land right next door.
Wealthier people use a lot more water. We found that overall, about 50%, if not more, of water is used on outdoor irrigation.
Kim Kardashian and Kanye West spend a lot of time on the red carpets, but this is the Green Garden property they call home. Keeping Up with the Kardashian star Khloe apparently uses a lot of water keeping up her lawn as well. The same goes for the estates of Jennifer Lopez, Jessica Simpson, and Barbara Streisand.
You got all these big, beautiful homes, beautiful lawns. How do you tell those people you got to let all that stuff go?
Even if you could afford it, you have to understand that this is serious, that this is a crisis, and that you're going to have to participate and play your part.
We reached out to the celebrity owners of these luxury estates through representatives, but none answered questions about water use. Many of these homes are in the Las Virgenes Municipal Water District, which says nearly 70% of the water it serves is used outdoors, primarily for landscaping. Next month, the district will start enforcing its new mandate to cut water use by 36%, and residents who use fresh water on their lawn more than twice a week could face a $500 fine. Beverly Hills is also facing water restrictions and fines.
The fines are not the answer to the question. The answer to the question is getting everybody to participate in conserving water.
We really need a lot of leadership from popular culture leaders who say we're going to change our behavior in order to make it safe for other people to do the same.
For CBS This Morning, Carter Evans, Los Angeles.
Message delivered.
Yeah.
Again. The pollen is so bad this year that some people who have never had allergies will be suffering. We'll show you what to expect and how to find relief. Plus, Yellowstone tourists learn to share the road, how a group of black bears is facing down the visitors said, back, back. That's ahead. But first, I know I love that picture too. But first, it is 7:47. It's time to check your local weather.
Temperatures are already flirting with the 70-degree mark, but visibility continues to be an issue. We are dealing with low visibilities all across central Virginia. And, of course, the rain is beginning to make its way, heading in from Anna. And, of course, we are looking to see more this evening. Kristen?
Thanks, Nikki D. Looks like we have some light delays due to congestion. Interstate 64 West working from Mechanicsville Turnpike. On that approach to the Shaco Valley Bridge, the left side of the screen, that's going to be the westbound direction if you're headed into downtown.
This portion of CBS This Morning, sponsored by Toyota. Let's go places.
Hi.
Hi, we're here to look at a Camry.
We just came from a birthday party.
Oh, let me get you a new one.
These Camrys are so reliable.
Yeah.
And you gotta love that bold new styling. Here you go.
Whoa.
Wow.
Those balloon towers don't make themselves.
During Toyota time, get 0% APR financing for 60 months on a bold 2015 Camry. Offer ends June 1st. For great deals on other Toyotas, visit toyota.com.
Thanks, Jim.
Thanks, Jim.
Now you both have Camrys.
Yay.
Toyota, let's go places.
Listen up. I'm reworking the menu. Veggies, you're cool. Mayo, corn dogs, you are so out of here.
The complete balanced nutrition of great tasting Ensure, with 9 grams of protein and 26 vitamins and minerals.
And now, with twice as much vitamin D, which up to 90% of people don't get enough of.
Oh, the sunshine vitamin.
Ensure now has 2 times more vitamin D to support strong bones. Ensure, take life in.
New Flonase Allergy Relief Nasal Spray. This changes everything. Flonase is the 24-hour relief that outperforms a leading allergy pill. When we breathe in allergens, our bodies react by overproducing 6 key inflammatory substances that cause our symptoms. Most allergy pills only control 1 substance. Flonase controls 6, and 6 is greater than 1. So go ahead, inhale life, excite your senses, seize the day and the night. New Flonase. Six is greater than one. This changes everything.
Brookside Chocolate now has a crunch. Brookside Crunchy Clusters. Crispy multigrains and sweet fruit-flavored pieces dipped in rich dark chocolate. Discover Brookside Crunchy Clusters.
Friends always look out for one another. We have each other's backs. And when it comes to protecting our best friends from fleas and ticks, we need to stay a step ahead. That's why at Petco, we're making pest prevention easy by taking $10 off Canine Advantix 2, Advantage 2, and Seresto, and $10 off Petlock Plus, a generic of Frontline Plus. Because our companions deserve to have protection. Petco.
Smash me. Dear God, smash me into a million pieces, little Miss Puffytail thinks every time someone enters this room. For while the people who come in here can use Quilted Northern, a toilet paper that works so well, they can completely forget their experience. Little Miss Puffytail can never forget. She can dream. Dream for the sweet, sweet swing of a careless elbow. Quilted Northern, designed to be forgotten.
You, my friend, recognize when a trend has reached critical mass. That's what a Type B does.
With E-Trade's Investing Insight Center, you can spot trends before they become trendy.
I want my foyer to smell more like a foyer.
I want his bedroom to smell like he's away at boarding school.
Surround yourself with up to 6 hours of luxurious, long-lasting scents. Introducing new Unstoppables Air Refresher.
Pain from your day can haunt you at night. Don't let it. Advil PM gives you the healing sleep you need, helping you fall asleep and stay asleep so your body can heal as you rest. Advil PM, for a healing night's sleep.
Visitors to Yellowstone National Park got an unexpected up-close look at nature. A black bear and her cubs roamed a bridge last week, and the tourists couldn't decide, should we run or should we take a picture? Well, the mother bear made the decision for them. She chased people who got too close to her little babies. A wildlife photographer captured this video. Montana's nature agency reminded people to respect wildlife. Once again, do not mess with mama bear in any form.
Yeah.
She said, I'm sick of these two-leggers. Get out of here.
That's scary. All right.
I like that video, though.
Yeah. All right, he helped transform special operations forces for their battles in Iraq and Afghanistan. General Stanley McChrystal is in our Toyota Green Room. We'll find out his blueprint for countering the threat from ISIS. You're watching CBS This Morning.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to your rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira giving me new perspective. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at work.
I live in the fine details. That's why I run on QuickBooks. I use the payments app to accept credit cards and everything auto-syncs. Those sales prove my sustainable designs are better for the environment and my bottom line. That's how I own it.
Introducing lunch at Outback every bloomin' day. Hurry in for all your Outback favorites. Plus new Aussie tacos, new savory ribeye melt, and our delicious burgers. Over 70 lunch combinations starting at just $6.99. It's lunch at last every day at Outback.
Allergies can distract you. So when your symptoms start, doctors recommend taking non-drowsy Claritin every day of your allergy season. With Claritin, you get powerful non-drowsy relief 24 hours a day, day after day. which is important because with fewer symptoms to distract you, you can focus on the extraordinary things you do every single day. Live Claritin Clear every day.
There you are.
Oh my gosh, lighten that!
Yes. All right.
How did you do that?
Expectation shattering service. That's the new Buick.
Fire!
Putting your finances in order. It's one of the best ways to start planning for retirement. At Voya, we can help you organize your savings and investments. So when the time comes, you'll have that orange money set aside for all the things you want to do. Like taking that road trip. Volunteering. Or simply spoiling your grandkids. Isn't that what it's all about? Start today, be ready tomorrow. Get organized at Voya.com.
Only 8 shows left. This week, Dave's got George Clooney, Oprah Winfrey, Julia Roberts, and former President Bill Clinton. Plus tonight, Howard Stern and Don Rickles.
Hurt in a car wreck?
Called the insurance company and got the no word.
Call 250-5050 and we'll tell them no.
We'll say no to unnecessary delays.
We'll say no to ridiculous low offers.
We know how much money you should get.
And we know how to get it for you.
And we get nothing unless you get paid.
All right.
Get all your money.
Call the Pendleton Law Team.
Because we know.
You know.
Everybody knows.
We're the heavy hitters.
Working for you, this is CBS 6 This Morning.
It is 7:56. Good morning, everybody. I'm Rob Cardwell. Hope you had a great Mother's Day weekend. It's a good look at the weather you're waking up to right now. Here's Nikki D.
Well, Rob, you know what? We're waking up to really warm conditions, almost 70 degrees, but that relative humidity, 93%. Moisture is prevalent, and we're seeing it in the way of fog. So be careful as you're headed out. Zero visibility right now in Louisa as well as Orange. 3 miles in Charlottesville, and you head into Richmond, where we are coming in at 5 miles. So make sure you are using extreme caution. Now, Anna is headed our way. We're already seeing a few isolated showers trying to push their way further up towards Williamsburg as well as into West Point. And we'll see more of this slow, steady rain as we go further into the afternoon hours. Temperatures right now, we are setting in the upper 60s to low 70s. But by the afternoon, we're headed back towards the 80s. Yes, 84 degrees, in fact, for your afternoon. We will be dealing with isolated showers and thunderstorms, not only from Anna, but also another system approaching from the west, moving off towards the east. Tomorrow, 92 degrees for the high. It's going to be one warm day. Kristen, how are the roads?
Thanks, Nikki D. Well, we've just picked up a new crash in Henrico, Interstate 95. It's going to be in the southbound direction close to Parham Road. So if you're heading into the Bryan Park Interchange, this could affect you. Just make sure that you are taking your time. The right side of the screen, that is southbound 95, and it looks like folks are able to get by, so traveling's open. The accident could be pushed over to the shoulder. Out to our maps, problems that you need to know about. Just picked up a new crash in Richmond's south side. This is going to be at Commerce Road and Ingram Avenue. So make sure that you're using caution there at that intersection. Looks like a little bit of yellow traffic, so that indicates moderate traffic there. You may have to tap the brakes. And Prince George, this should be in our clearing stages shortly. We've been dealing with this accident from earlier. It's Oaklawn Boulevard westbound at Temple Avenue.
New tonight.
Rise, get rise! I'm drunk with power.
The Two Broke Girls' new business is taking off.
You're our first customer.
Do I get a prize? Is it you?
How about a naughty selfie?
You were in this pose with your yobbles out? Didn't I raise you better than this?
A new Two Broke Girls. Then.
There are things in motion.
To say something big's going down on Mike and Molly. It's like saying this car needs a new roof.
I gotta go change my pants.
A new Mike and Molly after a new Two Broke Girls. CBS Tonight.
John's a service tech for 1 hour.
True.
He basically lives on the road.
True.
This is because people can save a fortune by upgrading their systems.
True.
And that is why John is so busy.
For maintenance and replacement programs, call 1 hour.
Now John's going to let me drive.
Not true.
Of all the things that keep you busy, maintaining your car shouldn't be one of them. The experts at Mopar are busy making sure of that. We get the job done right the first time. Help you save every time and get you back on the road in no time. So this spring, let us help refresh your ride. Right now, buy 3 tires and get the 4th for $1. at your neighborhood Mopar Service Center.
John's a service tech for 1 hour.
True.
He basically lives on the road.
True.
This is because people can save a fortune by upgrading their systems.
True.
And that is why John is so busy.
For maintenance and replacement programs, call 1 hour.
Now John's going to let me drive.
Not true.
CBS 6 Traffic, powered by James River Air.
Colonial Truck, your source for all things truck since 1966. Plus, we're Richmond's only Isuzu commercial vehicle specialist. We know the right truck to fit your business. From sale to service, Colonial Truck, the home of truck buying made easy.
DAFA Max 6 is sponsored by the law firm of Allen & Allen. The injury attorneys of Allen & Allen are here to fight for compensation for your injuries. Visit AllenAndAllen.com.
Weather to plan your day? CBS 6 this morning.
It is Monday, May 11th, 2015. Welcome back to CBS This Morning. More real news ahead, including General Stanley McChrystal in Studio 57. He shows his counterterrorism strategy to fight ISIS and his ideas on leadership and how they can help you solve your company's problems. But first, here's a look at today's eye-opener at 8.
The twister tore to this small community last night. This was a tornado that sent dozens of people to the hospital.
More severe weather expected through the day today from Houston all the way up through Memphis, all the way up into parts of Michigan.
Subtropical Storm Anna is a tropical depression this morning, spinning over the eastern Carolinas.
This is the impromptu memorial to those two officers who were shot. One was a decorated officer of the year, the other a proud newcomer to the force.
Saudi Arabia insists that this is not a snub, but it is a disappointment for the White House.
Michelle Obama talked about how she's learned to ignore criticism as America's first African-American first lady.
Can you tell us, is any of this true?
It's all wrong. I started reading the article last night. I got a third of the way through and I stopped because every sentence I was reading was wrong.
1.5 remaining. James for the win. It's gone.
This morning's Eye Opener at 8 is presented by Walgreens.
Ready, 7. Cue Charlie, South 7.
I'm Charlie Rose with Gail King and Nora O'Donnell. Two people are dead in Arkansas this morning as powerful storms ripped through the region. Suspected tornadoes destroyed homes and caused flooding overnight in the town of Nashville.
Earlier, an apparent tornado hurt more than two dozen people in a van in Van, Texas.